This is Harry. Let's take just a minute today to talk about how to perform qualitative risk analysis. Why do we want to do that? And then I'm going to share with you two methods on how to perform qualitative risk analysis. Now, why do we want to do this? Well, I assume that at some point in your projects, you as project managers have led some type of risk identification exercise with your project team, and you've got this laundry list of risks. The question becomes, which of those risks are most significant? I think of the Pareto rule that basically says 80% of the impact will come from 20% of the risks. So what are the risks that are most significant? So the reason we perform qualitative risk analysis, and for that fact, quantitative risk analysis, is to help prioritize the risks so that we have a sense of which are most important. So let me share with you two ways to do this. One that's a very simple, quick way to do it, and then one that involves a little more time, but it's fairly simple too. So method number one is what I call the KISS method. Keep it super simple. You know, if you got a small project, there's no need to spend a tremendous amount of time on evaluating the risk. You might use a scale like this: very low, low, medium, high, and very high. So for each risk we would go through, and on risk A, we might say that this risk is medium. On risk B, we might say that it is low. And we would continue that, then we would sort those risks in terms of those qualitative risk ratings. Very quick, but it gives us a sense of which of those risks are most important. Now the other method, which I prefer, is what's called the probability impact method. And it's fairly simple too. Here's the way this works. First of all, let's understand that probability is the likelihood that a risk may occur. The impact is the impact of the risk or the effect of the risk. So we would have a scale. For example, our scale might be 1 to 10 for probability and 1 to 10 for impact. Now, whatever scale you use, whether you decide 1 to 5, 1 to 10, be sure to give some definition to what is a 10 and what is a 6 and what is a 4, so that people that are engaged and involved in the evaluation have some idea of what those numbers actually mean. And so we would go through every risk. Risk A, we might say that we have a probability of 4 with an impact rating of an 8. And so we would multiply 4 times 8 and we would get our risk response rating, the overall risk score, that is, for that particular risk. And we would continue that process, and then I like to sort the risk by the risk score in descending order. That is, I want to see the risk at the top of the risk list, of the register there, that are most significant. Now, once I've done that, I'll define some sort of threshold. For example, let's say that I'm using this scale of 1 to 10. I might have a threshold of 80. That is, every risk that has a score of 80 or greater, those are the risks that I'm going to invest time in terms of development of a risk response plan. Okay? How am I going to mitigate the threats? How am I going to enhance or exploit those opportunities? And so I would develop a risk response plan, a contingency plan, backup plans, whatever that might be fitting to the risk at hand. So I hope you take a look at that. You know, it's just so important that once we've identified those risks, that we really get our arms around those risks that are most important. Do this with your team. I'd love to hear your feedback. Best wishes on working on qualifying your risk and evaluating your risk. Take care.